Alright, welcome back, and this is what the benefit of having a little time to sit there and think does. Yep. The assumptions were correct. I'm sure someone's gonna give me a comment in the previous video. No, you bitch! I took 3 damage! Are you joking me? And someone's gonna give me a comment probably like, oh, you need to spit eggs into the frickin' toll thing. He's like, yeah, I know. I seen it. Alright. Anytime I say something like that, I think of Aqua Teen Hunger Force. I forget where they're talking about, but Shake is like, I'm familiar with it. I can point to it on a map. That show's pretty funny. Old Adult Swim was really funny. And then they started doing, I think when they put on like 12-ounce mouse, is when it started to make the downturn. They started getting all these like really like Aqua Teen was a, you know, huge stoner cartoon. But it was still funny even if you were sober. And then meanwhile you have some of these other things like 12-ounce mouse and a few of the other shows that are purely 100% you need to be not only high, but like, I was gonna say just like super high or something, I don't know, but you definitely have to be inebriated or intoxicated or something in some way for those. So how can we, so you figured out like the main thing, that we can spit eggs into the tolls, but how do we get to the other spots now? I gotta figure that out. Can we hit an egg from here? That's gonna be tough. Oh, there's a piece in there. I don't think an egg can reach. It's not even on the same level. Oh, we could've went that way. Okay, so we have stuff to do. I was never over here, it looks like, either. Did I not jump and get those? Was I not paying attention? Oh! No! Can we lower this? Nope. It's alright. Not like we really need to. Oh shit! Before I was talking about, when the last one I was talking about working out, and I don't go super hard at the gym or anything like that, I'm not pretending that I do that, but can we? Okay. I really thought we could extend it further so I could pick those up. Maybe you just have to jump off and have faith. And praise the sun. It's nice that all this stuff is connected. It's kind of perilous having to do it, you know, on these narrow platforms. Got some out working out. And I mainly did it just because the last time I was actually in really good shape was high school. So I was kinda, I don't know if I want to get back to those times. Cause I actually, you know, I'm this weird, like scrawny, nerdy dude. Oops, put too many. But when I took weight training in high school and I actually got decently buff. So I'm not trying to get back to that, but like I'm definitely trying to lose some weight, tone up a little bit. And so far, like diet's been a thing. Diet doesn't bother me though, because I'm pretty flexible with my food. There are only a couple things I just don't like, and a lot of the foods that I have to use a. And a lot of the ways I like to enjoy. Oh, shoot. I'm not. There's no way. There's actually no way I can get over there. At this point in time, I feel like. Can I get up? Yeah, that's what I'm supposed to do. Is Sacred and Tilda gonna talk shit to me? No? So let's see how I'd have to do this. Let's take the mock run. Oh! Alright, so that is a factor. Okay, so we can make that. That's easy enough. I don't quite want to do that yet, though. Which I know is kind of weird. People are like, what? You don't want to go get the pieces? Because I don't want to... Because I can get there easily, I can't get back easily. So I want to look around a little bit. Yeah, so I work out for about an hour just at the house. I do, you know, the basic stuff, and then as much cardio as I can handle. Which, I don't mind cardio. Yeah, I was talking before about the... I guess we should do that, huh? Yeah, in terms of dieting food, a lot of the ways I like to eat my food is usually very lean and, you know, somewhat good for you, so... That makes it a lot easier, because I don't like cheese, I don't like to fry my foods usually. Fried food can be good, but I prefer, you know, like baked or pan-seared or something. Those are usually really good. I don't like beef that much. You know, like leaner meats, chickens, you know, birds, fish. So none of that's really been hard. And it's slowly paying off. Like I wasn't fat, but I'm definitely like losing weight, which is nice. I'm not getting toned up yet, so I feel like I just need to work out more. Because I used to get sore with what I was doing. I'm still doing more reps. Like, I keep increasing the amount of reps I do. But I'm not getting sore anymore, so I don't think I'm working out hard enough. So I need to probably work out longer and do some different stuff. That's been really helpful, because I'm looking for things to pass time in the day. Usually I just... So, like, I'll start working out and I'll turn on the stream or something like that, just have something to watch. It's pretty nice. So we need to... What's happening over here is the question. You know what, I guess let's get the puzzle piece. Because we actually have to do that now. So let's just work on this. Yeah, I see it. I should've jumped way sooner. For one, to get the extra height. Two, to get on the ladder sooner. Ooh. Wasn't too bad. Oh, we need to get out of here, though. They're gonna catch the bear! Looks like it stopped for us, which is nice of them. That should just be instant game over. Oh, what? Okay. Still close, still close. Alright, let's check these out a little bit. You have to guess. 23 is one number. Oh, that hurt. That hurt a lot. Oh, what? I dodged. I thought I did, like, special dodge. Okay. So three... I'm gonna say it's 3-1-2. You have to hit each one of these once. Okay, so is the puzzle longer? Alright, we're gonna stop before we die. So we need to keep our eyes out for some numbers. So it's 3-1-2. We can almost puzzle it out, but I don't know how many digits it is. So you need 3-1-2 something. Like, I felt like there would be a repeat there. It felt very fitting. I guess not. Oh yeah, something else I was playing when my internet was out was Neverwinter Nights 2, which is one of my favorite games ever. I think it's the first Obsidian game I played. So we can actually do this now that we... I don't know if we can actually get around? Oh, nice. Sweet. We got plenty of eggs, too. Alright, so we're doing stuff. But yeah, I have the base game plus a lot of the... Neverwinter Nights is a D&D style RPG. And eventually, I think a different company, I forget what it's called, but they made the MMO Neverwinter, which mechanically is a fun game, I've talked about it a lot. But it's not quite the same as Neverwinter Nights. Okay. Got some perilous bridges for this Toll 8. I'm surprised this doesn't move or rotate or do some Dark Souls crap. Yeah. The Neverwinter Nights 1 and 2 are a more traditional D&D thing, like, you know, you have rounds and turns, you have save throws, dice rolls, you know, stuff like that, but it's in real time, like combat stuff or whatever. It's really fun, if you like that kind of thing. I like those kind of games. And there were a lot of them, especially, you know, mid-90s, late-90s, early 2000s, there were Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, Neverwinter Nights, what was another one? We need to get all this health, by the way. It's imperative. What was another one? Pool of Radiance. That game was so fun. It was kind of buggy. And very... We almost have all the Gin Bros already. It seems like there's only one super well-hidden one. There has to be something under the ship. I'm just not eager to look there yet. Why do we need to raise the TNT? That's the other question. Or lower it. Alright, let's try. Actually, is this? It doesn't slope. Okay. I was playing Neverwinter Nights 2, and when you have the edition with all the expansions, it's the gold edition or whatever, they add a lot more things. They add a lot of, because the base game, Neverwinter Nights 2, had prestige classes, which they took from Neverwinter Nights 1, because I think they added that in the third expansion? I think they added prestige classes. So that was really cool. Neverwinter Nights 2 added more, and added different ones. And they did that, like, out of the gate. Cool, we can get into the ship, that's good. Alright, so we solved the major stuff so far. Like, I don't see much else to do out here. I'm sure there's something, but just from an immediate view, I don't see it. So that's actually pretty good. That means, ooh. Can we... We have to be able to make this jump. I think that's the only thing that makes sense. Oh, barely. Oh my gosh. Water's not moving either, that actually. That makes me sad. I know this is just because it's on the 64 and it's design limitation that they can't put like a world out there, but it creeps me out to see that. I feel so isolated. I feel so alone in this level, more than any other one. Just so cold and unforgiving. The wastelands. They're bleak and desolate. Yes, I was playing Neverwinter Nights 2 while my internet was down. I was playing a Warlock, which they is a newer class they introduced. Oh, shit. TNT box boss. Who dares enter boss boombox's hold? In a jigsaw, just. Is this just knocking him back, or is it killing him? Okay. Oh shit. Oh, it splits. They're multiplying. It's important. I think we should just one-shot the eggs. It's important to know, because it might be like a Mega Man mechanic, where they can only take like so much, like one hit of damage every like 3 seconds or 2 seconds or whatever, like you get the blinking invincibility. Which, this seems to be working. Oh shit. It's up to you, Kazooie. Banjo's literally doing nothing this fight. But then, they're not... What else are they not doing? Shoot. He's making this sound like they keep hitting him, though. Yeah. I was gonna say, they're not, like, blowing up on us. So I feel like we can... Oh, did you see him juke me? He juked the hell out of me right there. We should be killing the smaller boxes first. Actually, we should use the eggs on the smaller boxes. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, shoot. That's bad. That's bad. That's really bad. That's so bad right now. Egg spam! Shit. Oh! Oh, my gosh. We used all our eggs. Thank goodness we did all the toll stuff. Whew. I'm just gonna run into something randomly and die. I can feel it. Oh, you know what we could do? We can get that. I think that's what we're gonna have to do. Snacker's just gonna be down there. Somehow. He's gonna pop out and jump and just bite my head off. I was playing a Warlock in Neverwinter, which I was hoping would be more fun. It kind of wasn't. Just because, like, in that game too, what was really cool is they started adding a lot of hybrid classes. Just in the base classes and stuff, there's so much going on now. Oh, they just bounce off. That's okay, though. I need all of this. It looks like they do die, but, like, you'd have to use your whole freaking thing of that. Kinda sucks. Oop. Alright, we gotta find out what to do with the dolphin. It's kind of our last thing right now. Hopefully Snacker's not over there. I'll try and deal with him right now. I feel like it's such a dick move to put tough enemies or, like, unkillable enemies in water or whatever when you can't really do anything to do it, like, to hurt them or kill them or something like that. So let's see. There's probably someone under the boat. We need to get the porpoise. Alright, you're gonna have to tell me what's going on with you, dude. I'm trapped. I see this. Help. Get this thing off. Snorkel. How? I should have looked under the boat while I was here, but I'm really scared of the air supply. That was a band, wasn't it? Making love out of nothing at all, that's right, okay. That was a good song. Okay. So how do we free you, little dude? That's the question. What else is there? I feel like I could jump in some of these windows, but I can't get the, I need to? I've been in there. I haven't been in here. So maybe there's some over here. But I feel like I've done a lot of stuff on the outside and I've only gotten 4 jiggies and how many notes? 59. We're doing pretty good on notes, actually. There's another situation where it feels like there's stuff. There's more than meets the eye. I kinda wanna explore over here. But these bees are making it a complete pain. It's water. But there's stuff down there. I thought. I remember seeing something like an egg or whatever. So I have to go back around. There's a class pack or whatever you can buy, or not buy, but download to mod your Neverwinter Nights 2. It's got so many extra classes, I forget what it's called. Like, it's the creator's name, it's like his class pack or whatever. You get things like ninja and stuff, which is cool that they make a baseline ninja and, you know, other things, but part of the other fun in those kinds of games is to, what is it, like multi-class someone and try and RP or like create the class yourself. Where it's like, if I wanted to be, you know, Itachi from Naruto or something, how would I do that? Get a couple levels in Monk or whatever, get some skills there, and then get a couple levels in Wizard, and then focus, probably, you probably do Sorcerer, because Wizards have limited, like, they have to prepare and use spells in advance or whatever, but, you know, Ninjas, just use them kind of at will, and the Sorcerer is the kind of at will caster, so I think a Sorcerer would be better, even though Charisma's not a stat that someone like Itachi would have, but, well, for the fans, yeah, but not for the, not in terms of how it's actually used in the game. That's besides the point. Like, that's something I would do. You know, try and make a character that way. And then you specialize in, like, illusion magic and fire spells. So, you know, you can do that kind of stuff. It's really fun. That's why I like those games. I may still play it. I thought about, this was a long time ago, I thought about doing a Let's Play of, like, Neverwinter Nights. But that would be kind of, I don't know, it's, the action's not fast enough in those games for people. So people would really have to, for one, get down with the commentary, which I wouldn't be too worried about, but then also, can we, banjo? But then they also have to get, they have to get invested in the character. And that would help out a lot. That's part of the reason I decided not to do it, among the fact that it's just, it's a long game. The game itself is slow. And then you have things where, have I been up here, specifically? I don't think so. I probably have. Yeah, I have. But just, sometimes the combat takes a while. Where, you know, you might be somewhere you're not supposed to be yet, or There are a couple parts where, you know, you're, especially early game, where your mages don't do enough damage. You know, the enemies have a lot of life. And then you'll use a couple spells, and then, what is it? I'm just going up here to look around and see what I can see. Oh, I need to go under the ship, probably. Yeah, then, like, the combat will take a bit, because your mages won't do enough damage, and then you're just kind of relying on your non-magic characters to hit them, which at lower levels especially, you only get one attack, maybe two per round or whatever, so you basically get an attack every 6 seconds. I think it's a turn that's 6 seconds and a round's five turns or something like that, but basically you get one attack per 6 seconds. So it makes the combat slow as hell. Because if they miss, then you have to wait 6 seconds. And then you have to wait another 6 seconds. Which isn't, it's not bad to play, but I can see how it'd be very boring immediately for someone to watch. Later on, the combat's a little faster. And, you know, it starts getting better. Like, just from the viewing standpoint, just because, you know, the mages get cooler spells. The fighters and, you know, archers and stuff, the rogues, they get more attacks per round, so they'll be hitting a lot more, and the enemies and stuff get buffs, you get buffs, so there's just a lot more going on in the combat later on, which is cool. Plus you fight cooler stuff. It's not just, what do you fight at the start? You fight lizard men and some other stuff like dark dwarves, and this is Neverwinter Nights 2 I'm talking about, and then you fight a lot of undead. Then later on, you fight the cool stuff. You fight dragons and giants, demons. So that makes it more enjoyable. That's neither here nor there. We need to figure out what the hell to do here. What really kind of creeps me out, too, is that I'm low life. I don't want to... I could die very quickly in here. That's why I'm wary right now. Let's take one more look. Last night was pretty nice. I slept with my window open. It was raining. It was actually very relaxing. It was nice smelling the rain when I woke up. It was all wet. I like those things. California's not getting enough rain. Really sucks. So what are we gonna do? We have to go in here or something. We have to... I don't see anything else. Okay, so Snacker's not gonna be under the ship, I think, because we haven't seen him in the water around here. So he's only, like, in that pen with the buoy or whatever. So I need to check under the ship, and I need to check the anchor. Those are two things I need to do. I'm probably not gonna do them both this run. Like, this swim through, but... Is there nothing? I see nothing. Okay, so... I guess we just have to check the... call it the check the dolphin, then I'm actually out of ideas. I don't know if this will be a short video, but I'm definitely gonna take, because we're at 27 minutes. I haven't done too much this one. I thought I was gonna do a lot this run through because I was figuring stuff out, but that didn't happen. So I may just take a hot minute to just look around, I guess, and see what I can find. Cause I don't want to have to look anything up. If I don't need to, I should say. Maybe we can climb up the anchor and go on the ship that way. That's the only thing I can think of right now. So that worked. So that plan was successful. Get out of the water, the oily goop. I'm actually fine with this. These guys are usually pretty easy to kill. There are two eggs. I don't know if I want those. And then the chain goes up. It doesn't look like we can climb it. We could test that though. Let's go test that before we do anything else, I guess. I doubt I can climb it, but it makes sense. Yeah, okay. There are four eggs down there, I don't really need four specifically. Yes, please. Oh, shoot, I just lost it immediately. Come back. Oh, the anchor. These guys just look so happy and peaceful. Why is that one bigger? Oh, just insta-kill. Headshot. Alright, so we're doing the stuff. But again, this is kind of what happened in the mansion, where they're must be something else I'm missing. Oh, it just cut him in half, by the way.
Yay! I'm free!
So the anchor... By the way, every time there's rhyming in this game, I always think of Jumanji. It's like, in the jungle you must wait until the dice read 5 or 8. I don't know why, that just pops into my head. Can we look up? There's nothing. Okay.
Ah!
Oh my gosh. Swim controls, please. Let's reset our air. And then I will try not to be horrible at this game. No, I want the camera the other way, damn it. Alright, there we go. Just pick this up over here. That's 5. And then there's gonna be a Jinbro somewhere. And then after that, I have no clue. I honestly have no clue. What have we not done in here? We've thoroughly explored the ship, honestly. There might be something I'm missing there besides the steam whistles, but I feel like I explored the ship pretty well. Those warehouses, I don't think there's anything else in there. There's no point even breaking the windows, because you're just gonna go back inside, right? So, if you could even break the windows to begin with. I haven't been in this one, and there's something under it, so I feel like I can do something over there. And then I didn't... There might be something going on with that oil drum, like that biohazard thing. So, what can we do? I don't see anything down here, though. I don't see an open door, I don't see a hole. I don't see anything I can do. I'm sure there is something I can do, but I don't see it. Oh, there's a hole there. Never mind. Probably can't do anything there. The hole is well hidden just because of the... Was it the camera angle screwing me up? Oh, Jinbro! Oh, bastard! Gotta get the hell out. I might die. I might drown. Oh, especially when I do that. Come on. Because, like, it's one thing to... I knew it! Fuck! Oh, that's so shitty! I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. That's so brutal. It was my fault for screwing up, though. I shouldn't have screwed up. Well, I mean, we get all the eggs back. I don't really care about the enemies. The enemies weren't... I was taking a lot of damage, but the enemies weren't too bad here. I feel like you're supposed to do something with him. He's just sitting there. He's probably to teach you about the TNT boxes. Oops. Okay, so what? Oh, all the things are gone? Oh, that sucks. I mean, it's fair, but it sucks. Might actually have to use the stupid blue egg sheet or whatever in between videos. Just go over there and stock up. Would people be mad if I did that? If I went and I just used the blue eggs sheet? Because it'd be the same thing as me just farming eggs off camera, where I just, you know, reload a level. It just saves me time. You know, many people are like that. They don't want you to use tools in the game to do stuff. See, that guy got sniped and he wasn't even paying attention. It's fantastic. See, I want to check this place out over here. We have 5 pieces. No, 6. We have 6 pieces out of here. That means we're missing 4. And there are no Jinbros anymore to worry about, which is nice. We got those pretty quickly. Which I'm very happy about. I like doing things. Maybe you just have to puzzle this out. Like trial and error kind of thing. Three, two, one, two, two? Three, one. One, two, one. One. Okay, it's a double one. Three, one, two. two, one. It's probably, I bet you it's one like three times or something stupid. One, two. I knew it. I should have done it. It's kind of like when you take a test at school, and it's multiple choice, and then you answer C three times in a row, and you go, there's no way the next one's C. But C seems like the most appealing answer. That was it. Cool. I don't know if that was supposed to be trial and error, or if they give you the answer somewhere, but we just kind of brute forced our way through that. That happened to me on a chemistry test I took. There were six true and false questions. All six were false. Five were blatantly false, and then one was kind of... You're going, maybe... It was that exact same situation, because I was looking at it and went, maybe... This might be false, but there's no way that all six of these are false. And then I put true, and then it was false. And then I was very sad. Not that it didn't cost me my grade or anything like that, but... It sucked. I wonder if I'm gonna do that, because I was gonna. When I hit 500 subs, I was actually gonna get a webcam and do a little video, like talking more about myself, I guess, just what I do and who I am and stuff, but. The short end is I'm going to school for chemistry and I wanna be a chemistry teacher. And I'm trying to think of. I'm wondering, would I do that? If I made a test, would I be a complete dick? And just try and psych kids out that way. Because I'm a firm believer in having confidence in your answers. But there are times where, you know, it really messes with your head like that. So I don't know. There are three things I'm missing. I have no idea where they're at, so we might cut this here. Let's take one more look. There has to be something. I can probably get into the ship a different way. Because we did everything over there, we did everything over there, we did everything over here that I can see. I said I was going to check out this spot a little more. Because why is there a gold drum? I wonder if that has anything to do with what's happening. Let's take one look over here. We'll probably wrap up. Oh, we can jump over? Cool. Forgot about this. Is there a hole there? I don't see one. Because why is that one yellow and the rest aren't? Is it just random? Does it just happen that way? Which it could. It very well could just be a thing. Oops. So he couldn't. We break these though. That's gonna be the question. Nope. I guess it's just a differently colored one. That's all it is. I don't want to touch the dangerous biohazard, by the way. There might be something in there. Or there might not be. Who knows? I guess let's take one. Oh, I can't even go back that way. Forgot the bridge is up. Let's check the back of the ship real quick. Like how he just accepts it. And yep, I guess I'm dead. Whoa. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get to work editing right after this though, because I want to put up 14 today. It's the main reason I'm recording is because I need to put up a video. And this is the game that needs to go up. So I'll probably do 14, then I'll do part 17 of Two Human, which is the final one ever. And then it'll be this until I get the cables that I need, and then it'll be X4. As soon as I get the cables, I'm going to just start playing X4. I wonder if I can plug an HDMI cable into my PS2. Well, no, I probably can. That would make sense. I mean, if I had a converter, yeah. There are propellers. Can we get... Can we swim through those? Probably not. By the way, why are there propellers if the boat's not going anywhere? The heck, man. Alright, so we're gonna stop here. And next time, we'll hopefully finish this place. But we did open a couple other spots, too, so we can explore for sure. Like, we raised the water level, so we're not trapped here. So we may actually leave and just come back, so I'm not sure yet. But, as always, thanks for watching. And next time, we're gonna do something new. Or we'll finish this. I haven't really decided. Depends on what's happening. So... Okay. Okay. We're here. Interesting. Okay. I don't know why. I was just staring at it. No, this looks... If I can't... You can tell. Alright, you can tell. So I guess we'll do this next time. So there you go. Happened to find some at the very end. That's kind of nice. So yeah, I'll see you guys.